Kingdom Kids, we have made it to our final Advent video, Christmas Day. So we've looked at all of these different Advent series. We've looked at love, joy, peace, joy, and now we're gonna look at Christmas Day, Jesus, the story of Jesus. So for today, I'm gonna be reading for us Luke chapter 2, verses 11 through 14. And this is what it says. For unto you is born this day in the city of David, a savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased. So Christmas Day, it is Christmas Day. So you may have been born a long time ago, or maybe not so long ago, maybe just a few years ago. It always is crazy to me when I hear about how old you guys are and being born in the 2000s. I'm like, how can that be? But yes, it can be. So most births are pretty much alike, right? But there was one birth, one special birth, which was unlike any other. And it was the birth of God's son, the birth of Jesus. So Jesus's birth was like no other. Only his birth was announced by angels. Glory to God in the highest. Only his birth was a gift of love from God for the entire world. So it wasn't just for some people, it was for the whole world. And only his birth was the one that promised to save all people for all time from their sins. So today I've got an activity for us to do. So obviously your birth was special. There was one birth unlike others, and that was the most special, the birth of Jesus. But your birth was still special as well. So what you're gonna do as a family is talk about your birth. You're going to remember what time it was at, how much you weighed. And so I know you all probably have your birth certificate, but as a fun activity, you get to create one. So what I did was I found one online that was empty, and then I filled it out with some facts. So Miss Yvonne was born on June 10th. And we're not gonna say the year, although it's written on here. And she was about 6.5 ounces. And she was born to Mr. Roberto and Esther Alonso in the year of blank at 2:05 p.m. And so I was able to fill out my certificate. But what you can do as a family is maybe make your own certificate. You can draw it, you can color it, you can print one off just like I did. Talk about that special day. Talk about what your parents remembered and maybe find some baby pictures and go through that. And then at the end, thank Jesus for having been born in that manger in the town of Bethlehem, that humble birth, because his birth is the one that saved all people. His birth was so special. It was God's gift to us. And so some questions for us to meditate on as we finish this series is, why do you think God allowed his son to be born in a small town, possibly in a stable and placed in a manger? Why would God allow that? And then our last question is, why was Jesus born? So discuss that as a family. And of course, we know that Jesus was born so that we could one day be reunited with God in heaven, so that we could have salvation. He is our gift. So this Christmas, as you are celebrating with family members and as you are opening gifts, may you never forget the greatest gift of all, which is the birth of Jesus, our Savior. Let's pray, Kingdom Kids. Dear Jesus, we just first off want to say happy birthday. We are so thankful that you were born in such a humble way. You were born in the town of Bethlehem. You were born so that we might have salvation through you, and we thank you so much for that. Lord, if any of my friends or anyone watching does not know you as a personal Savior, we are praying that this Christmas they can open up their hearts and have a true relationship with you. Lord, thank you for our families. Thank you for keeping us safe. Thank you just for keeping us healthy during this pandemic and just for always coming through and providing. Thank you because you are the greatest gift of all. We thank you for our Kingdom Kids and for their families. We pray all of this in your precious name. Amen. All right, Kingdom Kids, I hope you had a blessed Christmas, and I'll see you in the new year. Bye.